Hi, I'm Anthony. I'm your rehab coach, your recovery coach. I have a couple of websites, as you can see, yourrehab.coach or anthonyrecoverycoach.com. What does Tony, that's me, Tony, what does Anthony think about your recovery? What are my attitudes? What are my beliefs? Well, I thought I'd word it this way because I wanted to talk a little bit really about what my beliefs of recovery are. What's really core for me? Like, what do I think, really? And how will that reflect on your recovery? I'm going to illustrate a couple of areas that I ventured through. The big area that I ventured through in my recovery was actually a process I call of values, and we're just going to put a little bit of a triangle here of values. And in it was approximately, wow, this was a while ago. It's probably mid-90s. I spent a good 3 to 6 months. It was about maybe 4 months, but it took about 6 months to really put together. I had an opportunity where I wasn't sharing a big house with friends or family or what have you. In other words, I was in my own place, didn't have a girlfriend at the time, so it was a very kind of quiet, solitary time in my life. It was about a year, and I spent 4 to 6 months really digging into what my core values were, my principle, the print, my you know what was I about? And I studied this book by a gentleman named Brian Biro. Beyond Success was the name of his book, and it's based on Coach Woden's John Woden or Woden of the University of California, Los Angeles, UCLA. He was the most successful college basketball coach like ever. I think he's like 12 or 11 or 12 championships in like 12 or 13 years. It was a ridiculous record, like impossible. I mean, and he achieved it. And he achieved it very systematically, but he used the idea of instilling values into his players. So I took on this task and I built my pyramid of values, this hierarchy where, my most important value was at the top and it was based on foundational fundamentals. So I spent a great deal of time really not only thinking, but developing my core values, my core, what it was I believed in for myself and others. And I came up with health. Health was my number one core value. Is actually to a great degree. I may have aspired to other things as well, but on a personal level, it's health. And spiritual health, mental health, emotional health, physical health, but just really health and well-being, on an individual level, okay? And everything else was secondary, or more importantly, foundational to that chief principle of or value of health. What does that mean? That means I'm really into healthy eating. I eat primarily everything is organic from a farmer's market and locally grown. I eat a lot of salads and vegetables. I've gone keto and carny, which means I don't eat fruits, in the tradition, like sweet fruits. Yes, I eat avocados and zucchinis, which are technically fruits, and sometimes cucumber, but they're not, cucumber is kind of sweet, but I've really steered away from the high glycemic type of food. No, I don't eat any candy. Yes, occasionally I will binge, but lately, as I've really adopted this carnivore type of diet, I haven't had a desire for sugar, like meaning sweets at all. Like I can go buy, the chocolate bars and the pies. For me, apple pies. Oh my God. Various different types of chocolate pecan pies. Holy gosh, rhubarb, strawberry rhubarb. Love these things, right? Nothing now. Like nothing. There's no desire. Why am I telling you this? Health is number one, and I really employed healthy eating as a means of betterment and longevity, good attitude, and all of these things. You see, it's not just about healthy eating, it's about what I'm consuming, good things, knowledge, information, books, ideas. These are all consumption pieces. What I'm putting out is actually more important than what I'm consuming, because what I create and put out there into my life, that's how I see myself. I don't really see myself as what I consume. I really see myself as what I put out. Perhaps more on that later. I'm a recovery coach, a holistic recovery coach. I believe in health. I believe in well-being. I believe in very healthy eating. I really reduced how much I supplement. I used to supplement a massive amount. I was constantly taking all kinds of supplements. I've reduced those, and now I'm not strictly, but I use a great deal of, like, when I say natural, I mean, food-based supplements. Yes, they're expensive. I don't take many of them, but what I do take are game changers, and I take them for a reason. I drop out a lot of synthetic stuff, except for B1 and B3. I believe those are pretty much synthetically based. But I've been taking B1 and B3 for, I don't know, 40 years. I'm not going to quit now. Actually, 45 years. Not going to stop. I'll keep doing it. And I also take a food-based source of vitamin B1 and B3 and the other type, the other B vitamins, on purpose with design. You see, I have correlated exactly my physical well-being to how I'm doing mentally, emotionally, my attitudes, my energy levels, my ability to sleep, my ability to be completely focused and not drifting off or foggy, because of how I eat, because of what I'm not eating, and because of my various energy levels and my fitness level. I'm working out, every 2 days I have a reasonably good workout. I'm quite active sometimes, but very sedentary for a day, possibly a day at a time, on the computer, doing videos, talking to clients. Sometimes I'll be standing when I'm talking to clients, and so on. So it varies, but my point is health is number one. When you're working with me, what do you think I'm going to be? I will have attention on it, but it won't necessarily be about what your recovery is about. I'm going to know intimately the areas that you're blind in when it comes to health and recovery. How do I know that? Because I know myself so well in this area. I mean, so well that I will be able to see and predict very closely what you can do to improve your health, what you can eliminate to improve your health, why you may not be feeling as well as you wish, why you're not sleeping as well as you want to, why you're oversleeping, why you don't have the energy, the mental clarity, you name it. I've done so many different types of detoxes. I understand how glutathione works, how to produce glutathione in the body, how to remove heavy metals, toxins. I work with specialists in all areas from top level, meaning centers that are charging a lot of money to get people off of or help people off of pharmaceutical dependency. That means psych drugs primarily. How's that even done? How's it done legally? How's it done ethically? I'm good friends with a number of facilities that assist with the most holistic and natural means of recovery. A lot of these natural means are spiritual, emotional, or mental counseling, mental type counselings, or emotional or spiritual type counseling, which eradicates traumas, which eradicates negative thinking, which eradicates impulsivity, whether you do that through myself as a recovery coach or go to a specific center for it, I can help. This is what I do. I'm a recovery coach. I'm actually a rehab consultant. I was doing that for over 20 years. I'm really familiar with the area. So what do I think? I think that health is a major, it's not just a major piece of recovery, it is recovery. Until you are healthy mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, and physically, can you say that you're through recovery? I wouldn't. Recovery is actually a longer process than most people are willing to accept. And why some may hang on to their last vestige of, let's call it sin, or call it, you know, vice, and consider themselves to be an alcoholic or an addict, while being completely sober or even straight edge for years or decades or longer. Why would they do that? Now, there's a philosophical and even a psychological reason for doing that. And for a number of individuals, it works. I'm okay with that. You see, I'm more interested in what's effective and productive and gets a good result, as long as the individual is knowingly doing it for a purpose. In other words, they're aware that they're doing it. It's not an obsessive and compulsive issue. So I'm okay with that. Buddhists and or the a lot of the Eastern faiths say that there are many roads and routes to enlightenment. Many. There are many, likely, as the same, there are many roads and ways to recovery. It is a different path, but it is a similar philosophy. The philosophy of enlightenment is essentially becoming more truthful with yourself, becoming more honest, becoming more of yourself. You could say it's a similar path to enlightenment. However, we're talking about drug or alcohol or pharmaceutical misuse or abuse. And for those individuals who are hardcore materialists, you may have an easier time or you may have a more difficult time because of your beliefs. Sometimes it's much easier for you and it works for you, meaning you've chosen a philosophy, materialism, that assists your life and your lifestyle and your recovery, which is great. I'm ready to endorse it with you. Or it may be contra your recovery, in which case you may have to toss some of that garbage out and replace it with what's really valuable. And when I say garbage, I mean garbage for you, not garbage. You see, you know, life is life. It's not good or bad. It's good or bad based on your consideration, not mine. Is it working for you? Does it work in all the dynamics, that means drives of your life, which there are many, I'm sure? Then it's good. If it doesn't, it's garbage and you got to get rid of it, you know? And if you don't, it's probably going to take you out or it's going to be part of your self-destruction. Not a good idea. That's something we can help with. I can help. When I say we, I mean me. I can help with through your recovery. Identifying, isolating, satiating you so you can have it or not have it, and then get rid of it as necessary. And then adopting really creative ideas, something that's really going to work for you. Maybe it's more materialistic. Maybe it's more spiritual, or maybe it's neutral. Or maybe it's more emotional. Maybe it's more connection. Who knows? You may have to actually disconnect or remove connections from some of the things and people and places that you've been. You may have heard that before. People, places, and things. There may be disconnection that you have to accomplish, not connection. All roads have a purpose and a destiny. The one I'm taking you along with on is the road to recovery. and it has an ending of you, true to yourself, happy, fulfilled. I look forward to your conversation, and I look forward to your recovery, and hopefully working with me soon. That's what your recovery looks like, and it may look like, and let's find out by creating your recovery together. My name's Anthony, or Tony. I'm a recovery coach.